Welcome to this session on Katalon Studio GUI. Today in this session, we are going to explore the very basic and major components of Katalon Studio. Let's get started. The very first thing is you have to start Katalon Studio. So in our last session, we have downloaded and started Katalon Studio on Mac as well as on Windows. So this Katalon Studio is running on a Mac and this is running on Windows. So whether you are following these sessions on Windows or Mac, it will be exactly be the same. In case there are any differences, I will let you know. So you can follow along these sessions whether you are on Windows or Mac. So once you have started Katalon Studio, you might get a window to activate your product by giving your email ID and password. So you can give the same email ID and password that you have given earlier while downloading. And then you might also get a quick guide window. So you will get a quick guide where you will get all these major UI components and you can go through this. It will be very useful and you can close it. Whenever you want to open it, you can go to help and go to quick guide and it will display the quick guide window to you. You can go to help and quick guide and yes, it will display it here, right? Now we have to go and look at the major UI components. For that, we might either have to create a new project or we can use any of these existing projects. So let me click on this sample web testing project so that we have these UI components activated. And now we can start exploring our Katalon Studio. The very first component is the main toolbar, or we also call it quick access toolbar. And this is a toolbar where you will find all the major and commonly used UI components. So let me just show you. This is the toolbar, okay? And here, let us explore this very quickly. You have these save icons where you can save your project. Then you have this new, where you can create any of the new test artifact, whether it is a test case, an object repository, and so on. This is very handy. We have this object spy. So if you click here, you will get a window where you can start capturing your objects from directly from a UI. So you can give the URL here and you can start on any of these browsers and it will create an object repository for you. It will be very handy when you are creating your automation test for your application. So you can capture all the objects at once and then use them in your test cases. Let me close this window. Let us go ahead and you then have a similar object spy for mobile. We have this record button where we can record our test cases. We have this run button where we can run our test on any of these browsers. We have a debug perspective where we can debug our test cases while we are writing. We have some issues, we can create breakpoints and we can debug our execution scripts. And we will see this in the coming sessions. We have this stop button to stop execution or stop recording. Then we have this build CMD button. This will be used to create a command line command for your test execution. So it will be very handy. You will not have to open the Katalon Studio GUI every time you want to execute it. Once your test cases, your test scripts are completed, you can execute it from command line. We have this icon for Git integration. So this is where you can clone, share projects and do all this push and pull from Git. And we will look into it into more details in the coming sessions. So this was the main toolbar or the quick access toolbar. The second GUI component is the text explorer, where you can manage and organize your test. So you can see this is the text explorer. Okay, and let us go inside this. So this is a very handy section where you can manage all your test artifacts, and you can see you have your test cases, object repositories, test suites, and all other test artifacts. So it will display your entire project in this tree view. Some of the very useful features are you can do a filter. You select test cases and it will only show you test cases. You also have this search icon where you can search for some particular keyword and it will show you all the matching options. You also have this advanced search where you can search by ID name and tag and so on. One good thing is that you can use this search as well as this filter parallelly, so that I am selecting sample, I am writing sample here and I'm also selecting test case here. So all the matching options only from the test cases will be displayed. So this again is very handy. Let me make it all and let me remove this. Okay, so this was the text explorer. This is something we'll be using very frequently in our test case execution and creation. Let us go to the next component, which is keywords browser. So let me show you this icon. If you see here, this is the keywords browser, and if you click here, you will get this window which will show you all the built-in custom and utils keywords. So this is going to be very handy when you are creating your automation test cases. You can directly go to this keywords browsers and look at what are the keywords available. For example, for web UI, we have all these keywords, and Katalon Studio team has done a very good job in categorizing these keywords into these categories. So for example, I want to look at all the keywords related to browser. I will click here, and now I can get all these options. So let me see open browser. So if I go here, open browser, it gives me a very quick information, and I also get this small icon for information. If I click here, it will take me directly to the browser, and it will display all the information about this particular keyword, which is again very handy and very useful. One more thing that you can do is, while you are creating your test cases, you can directly drag and drop these keywords from here, and we will look into it into more details in the coming sessions. So the next GUI component is the editors, and these are used for creating and managing your tests. Let us go to our test explorer, and for every component here you have an editor. So if you go to any test case, let me go to the login test case. As soon as you will click here, you will get this editors here, and if you see down, you have these four editors. We have manual, script, variables, and integration. In manual, you can create your test cases manually by adding every keyword and every actions through this add button, and then you can see your test case being created here. If you want to use the script mode, you can actually script in Java or Groovy and create your test cases. If you go to variables mode, you will see all the global variables associated with your test case. And in the integration mode, it gives us an option for integration with Qtest, which is a test management software. If we go to the object repository, any of the object repository, you will get an editor for object repository, and it gives us the facility to add objects or add identifiers. For example, if you can see, if I go to the login object repository and I go to this button login, you can see we already have this identifier by the name ID. You can add more identifiers here, and from this checkbox you can select which identifier to use for this particular object. So again, this is very handy. Let us go to test suite, and again, this is the editor for test suite, where you can add your test cases. You can click on the add button and you can select which test cases to add in this test suite. You can also check or uncheck this run checkbox, and it will skip the test cases which are unchecked. And again, this is very handy for managing your test suites. You have this editors for data files, where you can add your, you can click on the plus button and you can add. You can also add a new test data, and it will ask you what is the data type, whether it is from Excel, CSV, or some internal data or a DB data. Let us go to the checkpoints, and again here you have the editor for checkpoint. If I go to the keywords, you have the editor for keywords, and like this, for every test component you have an editor which can be used for managing and creating that particular test component. So this was all about editors, and now we have the views toolbar. So if you go to this right section, you can see this is the views toolbar. Okay, and this is again is very handy. So we have this icon for global variables. So you will find all the variables, all the global variables you have used in your project here, and you can manage it from here. We have this job progress icon, so it will show you whatever is your progress while you are executing your test cases. We have the console, which will give you all the logs. We have this problems section, which will show you if there are any problems. And then we have this log viewer. So this again will be very handy when you are running your test cases. It will show you all the information about your test cases, what are the passed, failed, and you can filter it from here. So again, this is going to be very useful and very handy. Now we have the perspective. So if you go and see here, let me just zoom it. So we have these two perspectives. We have a keyword perspective and we have a debug perspective. So the keyword perspective is what we have been doing right now, or as of now I am on keyword perspective. And when you want to debug your test cases or your test scripts, you will click on the debug perspective and you will get this window and all the options for debugging your test case. So this is something we will look into more details in the coming sessions. The next is we have preferences, where you can set your default settings for the project or for Katalon Studio. So you can go to Katalon Studio, and if you go to Windows, you have this Katalon Studio preferences. So this is on Windows, and from here you can set all the default settings for Katalon Studio. So for Katalon executions, you can do for Git, for test cases, you can do the default settings. In case you are on Mac, you will have to go to the Katalon Studio menu, and here you will find preferences. And again, you can do the same things here, setting the default preferences for Katalon Studio. We have a reset perspective. So if you go to Windows, you have this reset perspective button. If you click here, it will reset your perspective to the default settings. So in case you have done some changes and you want to go back to your default perspective, you can click here. Let us look at some useful tips. So there are some useful features on the UI of Katalon Studio. So if you go to the latest version and you go to any of the test artifacts, for example, I'm going to a test case, you will find a question mark icon here, right? So this can take you directly to the documentation for that particular component. So I am on test cases, and if I click here, it takes me to the test cases documentation. Suppose I am on any object repository, and if I click the question mark icon here now, it will take me to the object management documentation. So this is going to be very handy. You also have a command palette which gets activated by Control, Alt, and C combination, and this gives you very quick links to all these components. You can also start typing something and it will give you all the options. You can select open and it will give you this option. If you select it from here, it will directly take you to that particular component. So again, this is going to be very handy. You can report a issue. We have this help section and we have this report issue. You can directly report a issue, and this option is available after Katalon Studio version 4.4.5. It will not be available in earlier version. So you can directly submit a ticket from here. You can also skip tests. For example, if you you are in this test suite, and we have already seen that you can uncheck this box and it will skip the test. In case you are in the test cases and you want to skip a step, then you have to do a right click and disable the test step from there. So like this, you can skip the test steps as well as the test cases.